In January, the Minister for Housing, Owen Murphy, claimed he was making progress in tackling the homeless crisis. He said that the modest fall in the number of adults and children in emergency accommodation in December demonstrated that rebuilding Ireland was working. But yesterday, the latest homeless figures from the Department of Housing show a dramatic increase in adult and child homelessness. This is their second month that there's been such increases. There are now almost 10,000 adults and children living in Department of Housing funded emergency accommodation. And these figures don't include rough sleepers, don't include adults and children in Tusla funded domestic violence shelters, or refugees forced to use direct provision as emergency accommodation after having secured their rights to remain. More than 3,755 children last night slept in emergency accommodation in hotels, in B&Bs and in family hubs. In February of 2016, at the time of the last general election, there were 1,881 children in emergency accommodation. Since then, and on your watch, the number of homeless children has increased by 100%. In the last 12 months, child homelessness has increased by 50%. And this is the government that created a standalone housing department, Minister for Housing, that launched with great fanfare a new housing strategy that claims over and over again that money is no object in tackling the housing and homelessness crisis. Yet month after month, the number of people, including children, without a place to call home increases. The Minister's claims that he's getting to grip with the homelessness crisis is simply not true, and his position is becoming increasingly untenable. Tánaiste, you're a family man. Can you imagine your children living in emergency accommodation? I shudder to think if they were my children. Have you any idea what 2 years of homelessness would do to their development? Research by Focus Ireland, published last December, detailed the physical and psychological impact on children living in cramped and unsuitable temporary accommodation for months on end. Today in Morning Ireland, the Focus Ireland founder, Sister Stan, said, and I quote, "I have lost all confidence in this government's ability to solve the crisis." She said that rebuilding Ireland had failed and accused the government of failing to protect tenants at risk of homelessness. Yesterday, veteran campaigner Father Peter McVerry said that the government's housing plans were deeply flawed. He dismissed it as a stack of press statements aimed at primarily presenting a positive picture. And people are asking, at a time of economic growth, why is homelessness rising so dramatically? The answer is that this government is refusing to take the necessary steps to end the crisis. So, Tánaiste, my questions are simple. Do you accept that you are failing to tackle the homelessness crisis? Do you accept that what you are doing and not doing is making the matters worse? And will you outline what you will now do to get to control this crisis under control?
First of all, Deputy, can I say that I have visited and spoken to families and children in emergency accommodation. It does upset me. As an individual and as a father, as well as a politician that has responsibility, that we have not managed to make a bigger impact in terms of the number of children and families that find themselves homeless tonight. And that is why the determination of the government to change that situation is stronger than it's ever been. And if you look at the actual evidence in terms of what we have been doing, from last year to this year, the budget for housing increased by almost 50%. In the previous year, it increased by 50% as well. Money is not the barrier here in terms of the resources that are required to deliver a social housing programme. We have a €6 billion commitment to deliver an extra 50,000 social houses. The issue here is the capacity to be able to deliver the volumes at the pace that's needed to be able to get people out of hubs and out of hotels and into homes as quickly as possible. But I can promise you that in terms of policy initiatives or resources, there is no lack of will coming from this government. In fact, quite the opposite in terms of delivering. And so yesterday, the figures which did show a significant increase in terms of families, even though individuals who are homeless are down, but that's not what people want to talk about. People want to focus on solving the core problem here, which is families that are homeless. And we have asked the Dublin Regional Homeless Executive to prepare a detailed report in terms of what is happening over a number of months in terms of trends and why. And if that leads to recommendations in terms of change policy, well, then we will introduce new initiatives. But the core policy focus around rebuilding Ireland is to deliver a dramatic increase in social housing provision, as well as ensuring that we have stable rental markets in the future, so that we don't have the kind of property-driven economic implosion that we had over the last 10 to 15 years. And that the consequences, the social consequences of those policy mistakes, which we are now trying to fix, will not happen again in the future. So can I say, in the last year, 2,000 families have been taken out of hotel accommodation and put into long-term tenancies and better solutions for them. And we need a lot more of that, and we will have a lot more of that this year. And as we progress, we will see a dramatic increase in the number of social houses that are provided. Last year, 2,245 new bills. That's almost double the previous year. And we'll probably see that figure more or less double again this year. Up around 4,000 social houses being built, as well as a whole series of other solutions around voids, acquisitions, leasing, and an expansion of HAP and homeless HAP as well. So, you know, the accusations around inactivity and commitment are simply don't stand up.
Please, the time is up.
Punishment, not only are you not getting to grips with the homeless crisis, but some of your actions and your inactions are making the situation worse. Your government ignores the fact that there are hundreds of thousands of families out there who are barely getting by and are just one rent increase or one financial emergency away from facing homelessness themselves. You were offered 1,800 vacant homes, turnkey properties to purchase. You bought 400. You were told you needed to build 10,000 new social houses every year. You have delivered just half that. You were asked to support the Focus Ireland's amendment to protect tenants at risk of homelessness, and with Fianna Fáil's support, you voted it down. And every time, Tánaiste, you're given a solution to the homelessness crisis, you look the other way. This is why the number of adults and children in homelessness has escalated under your reign. That is why your plan is being condemned by those on the front line. This was your plan, Tánaiste. This is on you, along with Minister Murphy. Are you not embarrassed, Tánaiste?
Thank you.
Are you not ashamed? And can I ask you, what level of child homelessness do we need to reach in this state before Minister Murphy's position becomes untenable?
Tánaiste.
Deputy, you're trying to turn a very significant policy challenge for this House and indeed this government into a party political issue, as usual. And in terms of acquisitions, Deputy, last year the state purchased 2,266, which is an increase of 181% on the previous year. And we're focusing on acquisitions this year also, both with banks and with others, in terms of making sure that we can increase the numbers of social housing in the short term. So there are a whole series of actions that are taking place, and we will continue to, if necessary, change policy, take new initiatives to respond to the problems as they arise. Nobody on this side of the House accepts that the numbers of families and children that are in emergency accommodation, albeit much improved in the last number of years, is acceptable. It's not. And this government will not stop prioritising this area until the issue is comprehensively resolved. But that is going to take some time.